Eheomes turn to barrels. Eheomes turn to ban. Seconds remaining. 5 seconds remaining.
Mars TV Dota 2 League. We're getting ready to go into what is it? Phase 3? 4? 3?
This is the third heat.
This is the third heat.
Whatever. Sorry, you want to call it.
I tried to sneak in phase, but you wouldn't allow it. All right, so we're in the third heat. Secret versus Eheome. Eheome are coming off of two draws, which so that means they have 2 points, and the Secret coming off of one draw. Technically, they're coming off a break, so they got to feel rested and ready, but they also have 1 point. Both these teams would love to be walking away from the series a big 2-0, because right now sitting at the top of the bracket, or at least in their group, is Complexity, who are the only team so far that have a 2-0 series win. So what do you think here, Ben?
I think Eheome would also like to be walking into the series with 5 of their stable players. But
this is true. I received the news from Mr. Parker, and for those who didn't know, there are big Eheome fans out there. This is the first Eheome game on the main stream, so they are missing a player. CTY, unfortunately, is currently in hospital. I'm not sure exactly why. I hope everything is okay, but they are going to be running with a stand-in. I already forgot his name, but his fan.
Draft.
I hope I'm a fan of the fan. We should bring the draft up right now because we have loaded in the game. This
are
gentleman.
You a fan of the man.
I'm not a fan of the man, but I could be a fan of the fan. We'll see. He's from VG Potential or some tier 2 Chinese team apparently, and he has got big shoes to fill in the form of CTY. Here's our draft. Secret versus Eheome, game number 1, and Secret go right for the Earth Spirit here and Oracle. This is a 6.86 Secret team coming out. This is very different from them. We know Secret to be, very set in their ways. You're expecting a lot of the Puppy Chen, and they had a good rhythm going up to Frankfurt. But ever since then, it's been a bit shaky, and people would question, as they would question most teams, how are they going to adapt and conform to this new meta? Well, it seems like they're prepared and ready.
Okay, Oracle, the Batrider, pretty hard counter, I would say. It's super tough to get lassos off. Do very well versus the magic damage from Batrider. Unfortunately, it seems like teams still pick Batrider early, even though the Oracle's in a pool.
I don't understand that. I mean, even in the China qualifier, teams like CDEC were just going right for the Batrider right away, and they would even still play it in the offlane. So I'm anticipating this is going to be offlane Batrider for Eheome. That's how the Eastern teams seem to be playing it.
That's almost exclusively how Eheome.
Yeah, except for if you're EG or Alliance, these guys are putting Batrider in the front seat in the mid lane. So, and look at this. They're going to take their own counter and grab the Vengeful Spirit next. It is going to be a hard time. Oracle is very good. His Forte N obviously can get rid of and purge off any sort of sticky stacks. And then the False Promise is just an instant negation of the precious Batrider lasso. So,
yeah, Abaddon in theory should be okay, but his range isn't as good as Oracle's. Oracle's range is so absurdly far that You cannot be in blink lasso range yet still purge off the lasso.
But
so that's why he's especially good.
Oracle and Abaddon together is amazing. No, I'm serious.
I believe you. It just sounds ridiculous.
Insta pop the shield. You can flame your own ally with the shield on. It just insta pops it. All right. False promise. Let's say the Abaddon just runs in. It's like, I'll just take all the damage. Well, right before it triggers all the damage, you pop the borrowed time. And it will take all that damage and heal him up right at the end.
It sounds
ridiculous.
Need some disables.
Yeah, it's pretty funky. Heaven forbid there's an AA that pops up on the other team, but just something that I've seen a couple of teams like DC experiment with. Eheome, third pick, OD. He's back. He's black. And he's beating a lot of ass, man. So it's a lot of mid-late domination here. Secret do have a couple outs. Who do you think are your top contenders going against them? Typically teams like your, Viper, Razor.
Invoker.
Invoker, of course, the mighty Invoker. The Wii Invoker, it's a thing. I've seen it a couple of times.
Why not, dude?
Why not?
Invoker is always why not. Why not Invoker? Why not?
I mean, they don't have... I feel like Weeha's more of a Quas Exort kind of Invoker player.
You can play both.
I don't see a lot of like Sunstrike potential here. between like Earth Spirit and Oracle.
Even the Fortune's End. Fortune's End and Sunstrike that we've seen a decent amount.
Really?
Fortune's End, yeah. Huh. We saw it a decent amount last game.
Nice.
Well, you have to have practice a lot with it though, but even then it's not that important. Ooh, Lone Druid. So Lone Druid's interesting. We didn't really see it touch. It just seems very hit or miss in some regions, but I generally think it's very, very strong versus OD because you can't steal and off the bear, and it's OD is notoriously weak against like just heavy push too. Like he doesn't like getting up in there. Getting up in there, dude.
Sometimes you just got to get up in there, though.
Well, you have your cores that get up in your face, like Batrider,
yeah.
Lone Druid with the bear, and then OD.
That.
OD's like, I kind of always want to skirt around the edges and get as much intel as they can, and then just drop a huge Sandy's Glove. That's what you want to do, right?
Yeah. But Sniper and Drow right there, like, yeah, I don't hate when they get in our face.
Oh, yeah.
Now this is fun.
That's spicy.
But why now? You figure Pugna's typically like, it's time to push, boys, let's go. Nothing about their draft right now really says it's time to push, let's go. So why did they get a Pugna?
Why not push and let's go? With Batrider, you force people to fight under the Pugna ward. That's a big problem with Pugna ward. People just run away. And then you're kind of like, well, we want to fight around this, but we can't really fight because we don't have a way to like get people in. But with Venge Swap, with Batrider Lasso, you force people to fight in a Pugna ward, and then you're like, oh crap, we have a Pugna ward. It owns Oracle. Like,
can't
what's Oracle
like,
going to do?
Send a bear in there and just get rid of that war bear.
No, it's a creep. It doesn't. I don't think it does full damage to the. I could be wrong on this. I'm not.
It's
positive.
Amount of attacks to take down the ward now. I believe that.
Yeah,
was
but it's a differentiation between creeps and heroes.
Oh, really? It works like that, too?
It's like the Visage Birds. It takes, like, you know, X amount of hero hits, and then it takes, like, 3x or 4x amount of creep hits. And I think the bear actually does kill as a creep. I'm not positive on that, but I think it does.
Dota and its mechanics. I guess we may get that answer in this game, but I don't know. I guess the initial, from what I'm seeing from Ehome, is, yes, you're right, it does force great fights under towers in heavy pushing situations, but I guess it doesn't feel like that their heroes are very good at wiping out their
creeps.
Even
run it differently too, though. They run it a lot just for the Nether Ward, which is.
I mean, it's ridiculous. I mean, it gets like Earth Spirit. I know when I go into a ward, it's like this is a nightmare.
The Oracle, too. I feel like it's just gonna get destroyed because you almost never build HP on Oracle because you don't need it, but this game you do, which is
the well, his stuff does cost pretty damn cheap. So the ward isn't going to do a crazy
amount. He casts so often, though.
He does cast a lot, but yeah, well, you cast three things, and you're like, okay, maybe I shouldn't cast anymore.
Yeah,
this
but
ward
yeah,
is
like,
it,
what are you going to do, cast Purifying Flames once in a team? That's useless.
Just your positioning away from the... With Aether, he might get an Aether Lens and still be out of the range of the ward.
Dude,
and make
the Pugna Zap is just, like, two screens away. Not two screens, one and
it's pretty
screens.
Long, yes, but with an Aether Lens, he might find a position. It's funky, I love it. Now this says let's push.
They don't want to get in there, dude.
Are they going to get up in there and see? See
they are going to get in there. They have Spectre.
They're going to do it now doggy style, apparently. So
they're getting in there.
They're going to get up in there here. So what does Secret have to do? They've already committed now with a hard late game carry and what feels like relatively a pretty greedy draft with this Spectre.
Invoker.
You're right. There's
oh,
that.
Actually, Invoker gets crushed by Pugna. Oh,
is
man.
We got to remember the Secret. What about Meepo? If I throw out a casual Meepo, does that seem too crazy here?
It seems like they would still get destroyed.
That might be way too... A Meepo, Spectre, Lone Druid on
that's
the same
way
team?
Too greedy. Shadow Fiend? Shadow Fiend's in
how do we know that Weeha doesn't play the Lone Druid? Are we
I mean,
for certain?
He can.
He's a micro guy.
But
he
what,
might
is,
be playing.
What does Misery play that salvages this...
Misery? I don't know. He plays like Magnus a lot, but that's not going to work
here. That's not
going
to salvage.
It's
too farm intensive.
What does he play a lot? Potom?
Clock's useless. Coddle? Coddle.
Misery Coddle? Earthshaker.
That's...
Earthshaker. That's good. It can cut off the wolf, trying to make a getaway, locks him in place. He has all the necro books typically.
Oh. Whoa.
Ticking
whoa.
Time bomb.
This is a mid earth spirit?
No. Oh my god, it's a Weeha earth spirit. This guy, he is a really good earth spirit, and he does play it mid lane. Before he was the Weeha we used to know, Balkan Bears, like, obviously a very heavy driven Meepo player, but he played. Earth Spirit just as much. In fact, he's top two at the time.
What's EOTK mean?
EOTK? I don't know. ROTK's brother? Eric OTK? I don't know.
Typo?
Yeah, it's a mistype. I am NVOTK, brother of R. R-O-T-K.
I mean, OTK is one turn kill.
I can't believe it. Is he actually going to play it mid lane, or are they going to make some sort of crazy swap around? I mean, they could put... Misery mid lane with the Lone Druid, and then just have him... Because that's the thing, is when I watched him, and I'm telling you guys, when I used to Fiend or Spirit, especially when everyone really frowned upon it, I would like watch the YouTube videos of the top players, who's doing what, and he has an amazing highlight reel of Urspear plays out there. Are you sure he's mid? He's at a ward.
Look at his build. He's saving him for bottle.
No, he went early roll. I mean, that's just common, I guess. I feel like he's going to be going into a support position here. I really do. I really, they're like...
Support? What
but Pylai Dai used to play it, right? He was trying it out for Secret. But the thing is that Weehaw is a very high caliber Urspear player.
Like, yeah, but who's going to play mid?
I'm just saying, like, maybe they might put someone else to the mid lane.
Like what? Earthshaker?
I was saying, like, Lone Druid, but it does look like they are going to be throwing him around there. So he's going to rush a bottle.
It's a mid. Yeah, that's what it looks like.
Okay. Oh, he already lost his ward, so that sucks. Hey, you got the deny, though. Nicely done there, senor. All right, so is Puppy playing the Oracle or...
Nope.
Puppy's playing the Earthshaker. So Misery's playing the Lone Druid. All right. This is very different from Seeker right now. So I'm trying to wrap my head around this whole thing. Ehome, I suspect them to always be more rambunctious with their picks. We saw it even at Frankfurt. They were one of the first teams to start pulling in the Abaddon as a support, especially against the hefty, you know, Slardar Bane era we had.
Dude, I have a feeling they're just gonna get trucked by Pugna Lycan.
Really?
Like,
I mean, it's a it. Yeah, that ward could definitely creep on you.
Their anti push is just awful, and I guess maybe a core Earth Spirit can salvage it, but I haven't seen a core Earth Spirit in like a mid Earth Spirit, in so long.
Back when the pull did a stun, you know, it was like the old chapter, the old testament of Earth Spirit when he was god tier OP. But this is, you know, in a core position. You saw me, I played offlane Earth Spirit. It was an absolute disaster, but I still like Earth Spirit in a core position.
I think he's okay in core. It's just mid. It's just like...
But yeah, he gets an OD for god's sakes. This is just a nightmare. I you know, best of luck there, sir. But we'll see. Maybe he's just in it for the
what
XP.
Does he do, kick for CS?
He might just like get quick XP and then go to work starting at level 3 or something. Attack another lane and use your maybe 2 into Q, 1 into W combo.
So do you know anything about Fan?
I heard he's the man. But no, I really don't, except for what Parker told us before. Formerly, or he plays for a tier 2 Chinese team, I think VG Potential, and is now filling the shoes of CTY while he's out. But is he playing the same position? Is he playing mid lane?
No, he's playing safe.
He's playing safe.
CTY playing safe.
Okay. Oh, yeah. Can't forget Mr. Old Polio. I just haven't seen much from Ehome for so long. You got Ehome, OG. A lot of these teams have been really... VG even, you know, out of the picture for like a month now. And hopefully this is going to be a good stepping stone towards the major as they find their groove in this new meta. But what do we think about this bottom lane matchup here? The unorthodox Pugna Lycan dual safe lane. Is it enough to zone back and create some trouble for this Lone Druid? I can't help but feel
you can harass the bear a lot.
Yeah.
You have the right click from Pugna. Pugna is very fast. And you have some hell damage. So, yeah, 330. Look at that move speed, dude. That's insane.
He's like second fastest in the game. It's pretty ridiculous.
Ooh. Is he gonna do crap?
He's got the time. Oh. It's a long range. Gotta damage it though. He got it. Oh, what?
Yeah, he resummoned.
Oh, it did go down. Oh, well, the meanwhile, it does look like Old 11 is gonna be picking up the first blood, and none other than Pylai Dai will be going down first, unfortunately. Gotta keep tradition alive though, I suppose. But.
Oh, yeah, I forgot about Old 11. He is so good on the initiation heroes and.
Tusk.
Very unwieldy on the non initiation heroes.
That is a question I didn't really get the chance to like pose when you really look over the two teams going toe-to-toe is players like 11. Now that Tusk seems to not really be all the craze here, what does he really offer outside of that?
If you can play Tusk at a high level, I think you can play a lot of other heroes at a high level. I don't think he's like a one-and-done kind of thing.
Maybe it's more of a matter of how polished is he on the hero.
Yeah.
You know, fresh, not rusty, of course. used to maybe the new reaches of the Batrider, let's say. So
some of the other heroes I saw, like his Shaker, I think was really, really good too. And those kind of heroes are like not easy to.
Oh yeah.
It's hard to just be good at Shaker and suck at everything else. That's even more difficult than being good at that hero.
So we briefly looked at mid lane, and we're not surprised to see Weehaw 5-0 to OD 17-7. But look at this, making it go for Fan here, and he got trapped out by a Fissure. Nicely placed here, and the Lycanthrope is going to be going down. Secret get themselves on the board.
It's a really good block.
Really good block from Mr. Puppy here. And another one going to be coming out. This one is just going to stun him a bit, but it looks like Vengeful Spirit's going to be able to creep in and offer some assistance. That's Kaka right there. Top lane, Pylite die. Be careful, my man. Lots of stacks building up right now. It looks like 11's going to be going to the skies. He's looking to run in. Fortune Zen's going to lock him in place here, and he decides to make a 180 and step back. But they are going to be walking through the fire. Pylite is going to be forced to stick up. And 11 will be able to make it away to safety.
Both safe lanes are not going well, though. Like, Lone Druid's getting a lot of farm, and the Batrider's getting a decent amount of space.
This lane's going fantastic for Old Chicken, though.
What do you expect?
I mean, this is melee. Just a ballsy move coming out, so I got to see where the payoff's going to be.
Maybe he gets a haste or something, though.
That's true. Mm-hmm. It's a bounty.
Sad boy.
It's a bounty. But he's almost level 6. I have a feeling that he has to get his level 6 and put his Magnetize to work right away to just kind of make up for, obviously, handing over the freebie lane to OD at this point.
So when is Pugna going to start getting his ward? He's, what, 2-1-0?
Right now, I'd imagine. I don't see many Pugnas go above one level up to crap.
But then it's...
Oh?
It's really slow as a support Pugna, though. You want to max that thing very quickly. If possible.
I guess just one blast, though, doesn't really give you a lot for the...
Yeah, it doesn't.
It just is so... It's like a big pillow.
I wonder if he's going to get, like, 2-1-2 or something like that, though. Or skip his ultimate.
I'm for sure. That's true. Yeah, ultimate level 6 really doesn't offer too much. I think his ultimate overall doesn't offer a lot. I would not be surprised if he got some loving in the future. Compared to something like Soul Siphon, Pugna just doesn't stand up. But very passive stuff so far. Old Chicken just content with the lane advantage he's got, and yeah, Weehaw is going to casually harass slash snipe some CS with the benefit of his boulder smash. And he does always have that kind of, you know, escape mechanism with the boulder to kind of make it away from trouble. So, I mean, I guess it's a nice thing. He's free to kind of get the easy XP, but still is struggling a bit in the farm department as it is right now.
So it's a fighting build from EE with the phase and the urn. That's together. You know that's the kind of game it's going to be, though.
Yeah, Magnetize and then Haunt going to be coming, I'm sure. Fan, in trouble once more. Going to be going down again this time. Going to be picked up from Misery here. There's the ward. Already an early commitment. It does hand over a good chunk of change, though, if he wanted to take it. Does the bear hit it? Oh, come on, camera. Oh, well, now we'll never know.
It got denied, so I think it... Uh-oh.
That kick. Ooh. Oh, nice sidestep coming up from Lanham. Woo! He is going to eat the magnets there. That's way too much damage already. Pugna is a frail little boy, and he will be going down. It looks like it's going to be a second kill. That's more than enough magnetized damage to also take down Kaka. That's what I'm saying. He gets his first one, and look at this. He's going to walk into it as well. I doubt he has any more stone remnants, so and one more. Not worth it if you need to get away. It's And looking over their team, they don't have any natural way to dispel it. A lot of heroes now, you know.
OD Astral.
It's good OD enough. Astral. Is fine.
Soul Siphon?
Do you think it's
train?
As much of a problem that you need to get a BKB slash Yules slash
that's not,
something?
That's not their strategy is based around. Their strategy is based around taking towers. So they just need to mech it up.
Going for that means you're giving up, essentially.
No,
gotta move forward with the game plan.
You go mech. You go mech, you rely on Pugna War to deal with their spirit.
Mm.
They kind of have to end the game pretty early. Mm. At least take down towers very early, because that is what their strategy revolves around. So I don't think it's going that well for them, though, because the Lone Druid has gotten a lot in the offlane. He's not super high on CS, but the amount of work that he's done on killing the Lycan twice, pressuring the supports, you know, kind of contesting that big camp, like it's not all good in the world of E-Home safe lane.
I mean, it seems like Kaka has been stuck in this bottom lane. We're not seeing a lot of movement. I mean,
he was sitting mid, but there was a reward just, you know, kind of saying hi to him. So.
Yeah, and now that I recall, like, he might have actually made a gank attempt for Weehaw, but Weehaw was able to make it out. All right.
Oh.
Puppy just says, what's up? Oh, thought about maybe rolling forward. By now, Magnetize should be back up, and he probably has like 3 or 4 stones. 4 stones ready to go. I mean, that's plenty to be able to get a one-on-one takedown, pretty much.
Wow, that stun lasts a long time.
Yeah, he decided to max it. I mean, I guess because it's a core position, you don't really need to worry about getting into the silence too early. When you want max damage, you max Q. Plus, the silence costs a lot of mana, and he only has a bottle.
Once they get, like, Tread's Veil, though, or I don't actually know who's gonna rush, but I assume someone's gonna get a Veil at some point. That's actually pretty devastating to deal with as Yuhom. Or you can just, like, get a Scepter and just...
Yeah, I really don't know. In a core position, like, I think even Aether Lens is pretty nice, but on a core, I don't know. Veil might also be good. That's a real snowball-y kind of item that would work.
Nah, that cool. I was like, man, that cooldown is sick, but he had Arcane Root on.
And it looks like with the retreat there of Little Anima, this is going to lead to a easy tier 1 takedown of the bottom lane for Secret. It's only 2 to 4, but now we're going to see some movement towards these tier 1s. The Lycan kind of coming together. This rids of that casual waypoint for Secret. If maybe a Roche wanted to be done in the future for Ehome. And they're also making a move towards the top lane. A hopeful attempt to maybe go for EE. Sama, can they get it done? They got the Decrep. He pops out the haunt, but the lasso's going to be there. Holding him right next to the ward. Will turn into his gravestone. And they get a successful pick onto the Spectre.
As well as taking using the haunt cooldown. That's good.
Yep.
And that should be a Batrider's Blink.
Let's see. Yes, it is. This plus the tier 1.
I mean, it's incredibly good timing.
Oh, yes, sir. I mean, it's obvious. I mean, the Batrider was in pretty much a 1v2 setup. Puppy was moving around a lot. Oracle alone is just not going to be
doing anything.
What's
Oracle's level? If he doesn't have level 6, it's back.
Oh, hello, how you doing right there? Bada bing, bada boom, there's a Magnetize, and he beautifully gets the both stun, gets the Magnetize on the 2. 11, though, nice quick TP, is going to make him out and save him. That's a good heads-up play right there. But
yeah, he's looking scary on this Earth Spirit though, for sure.
This is the big peak of Earth Spirit's game. I would say of the whole game, like if you're a core position, yeah, this is the window. You got to make the most of it right now. And then hopefully he gets a lot out of it. And then you just kind of go, okay, Envy, your turn, and you take over the lake. And plus you have the insurance policy of casual misery, lone druid. I mean, this is a solid game plan here.
Except he's about to get lassoed and burn.
Yeah. Let's see. Oh. Ehome really need to drive it up right now, though.
Maybe not. Hello? Haste rune. Wait, what's Oracle's level? Is he like 4 or something?
Oracle is 4.
Oh, that's not good.
Yeah, they're like...
So Bat has like free reign for like the next 3 minutes while no fall.
Yeah, that's... Oh, man. That is interesting. Oh. They get a kidnapping here, a pullback onto Misery, right into a beautiful Pugna Blast, and the Drain. That has a lot of risky damage, plus with the ward pre-placed. Good solo pick right here from Eho, make him 2 back-to-back mid lane. Meanwhile, a roll on 4, they're going to get the stun and the pull combo coming out. Nicely done from Wii. And it's going to be a trade from both sides. It's a lone druid takedown, though, for the support Venge, and it's going to lead to a tier 1 takedown in this bottom lane for Eho. Or Ikasa, I like Dalton.
Ikasa?
Sukasa. This Pugna is just saving up a lot of money right now. What is he? Does he have 1800 gold and his boots and a wand? What is this Pugna saving for?
I assume he's a mech bearer.
I guess straight to the mech without getting anything along the way here. Haunt going to be committed as they make their move for the OD. Long kick is going to connect. That guy is a FIFA player for sure. Pullback silence, roll forward, and it's a strike.
Pugna was not interested at all saving him. Like, I'm going to die too.
Well, you can't really decrep him. It'll only do worse.
You can heal him.
Yeah, but it's like at this early with only boots and a wand, he's like, I barely have any life. I'm not gonna give you any.
What's he gonna get though?
I don't know. Well, he's gonna get killed. Kick forward stun. Okay, drain it up, baby. Yeah, that drain's gonna stop with a quick silence. Oh, Yeehaw, suddenly mega kill. And if Secret continue this here and Ehome are unable to break this momentum, I think this is gonna get a lot of other teams kind of wary of this Earth Spirit on Secret, especially if it ever shows up again in a core position. But we'll see. We got to see what the bounce back factor is going to be for Ehome. Lanham, what the hell is he saving up for? The mech is nice, but it doesn't really add HP, so he does have to be very cautious of his positioning.
Oh, no.
Looks like they get a pullback for Misery here, caught up in the jungle. Couldn't get him on the high ground, though. But they get the bounce back, almost get him up there, but plenty of burn power coming out, and 11 on a killing spree, but rolling on into power right now is going to be Weehaw. Drops down a big Magnetize here, and, well, as they try to step back it away, they are going to get Weehaw down, and the follow-up here for Pie Die. And look at Ehome just run a train on through Secret now. They take down three. They're looking for the fourth here. They nip them at the heels here with the power of the Wolves. They are going to be able to bring down EE. Make it five all day. Well, I thought Secret were doing pretty well, and suddenly Ehome just wiped them.
That's what we call getting in there.
They got up in there, and Secret realized, what the hell happened, and was I drugged? And suddenly Ehome are now going to be pressing for a tier two. Their Roche potential is at their convenience when they can get one up and at the ready, but...
Misery is not respecting the Batrider. What he needs to do when he gets lassoed is immediately return the bear and then use the roar. I think that's his best bet. But if he does that, actually Batrider just runs close to his base, so maybe it's not even that great. I guess he has to return his bear and then, like, as soon as the lasso ends, cast it, but it's rough.
Pi needs to be in position and level 6. It's gotta be level 6 by now, sure.
They need Oracle to be 6. That's actually
the big one. Okay, hey, Bear wants to scout out what's happening, but they just throw him right into an Astral, and they are going to be able to grab it. Ooh, tempting hot play here, but there's going to be no commitment inside the pit.
Yeah, don't fight with that Pugna Warden on the high ground. If they fight in the pit, they'll get mad.
I love that change. Pugna able to kind of select the positioning of the ward now. It just makes it so nice.
Yeah.
Get it up to the high ground, and...
He's getting drawn away from the ward, though. This is not that great for them. They
don't want to go up in an awkward position, but they have vision up there.
I mean, they got what they came for. They got the Roche.
Mm-hmm.
It's good enough. Well, it's bad. Whatever. He has Spores. So now comes a trying time where you want to seek farm out on your Lone Druid and your Spectre when they're still very weak, and the Ehome are just on a roll.
Yeah. How's the Veil coming along for Wii? They might need Wii to kind of continue to be a big problem here.
Wait,
oh, that's Double Robe? Orchid? I never heard of that before.
No, that's a Veil. It's definitely a Veil.
That's a Veil?
It's a new upgrade.
Oh, you're right. Goes to show I have not been building Veil lately.
Neither has anyone else.
Except for this guy here, but we also haven't been seeing a lot of Mid or Spirit, and I don't fault the item choice this game. It's just now it's like, okay, well,
it's just weak because
go.
Lone Drew is Radiant. He had a great start, died twice with his Midas. Not good. Spectre, died twice. Also, so they're still in an okay spot. They're gonna lose a lot of towers off the back of the Aegis, but they just need like 6 minutes of farm, and then it will get Radiance, and then one more Idol Inspector.
No, level 11 on her spirit would be great too. He's only 9, about 10.
Yeah,
like...
maybe Blink on Shaker. Like those are what items you need. But Ehome are like, we are not giving them any time.
Blink on
at
Shaker.
All.
That might be a bit. I don't know. Third and from second to
The Ethereum's
It's wonderful. I mean,
getting
a lot of zaps. But it was defensively on himself. That means that no one's going to be saving Little Weeha here as he does get lassoed up from 11, easily burnt up and taken down.
This is how you deal with the Oracle, though, as a Batrider. You pressure him and make sure he uses False Promise early. And then once that, you're like, oh, I'm free to lasso whomever I want.
What a foley. And a Puppy is going to be forced to Echo, but it's. Not going to be much to deter Fan, not till he makes it into the high ground here.
Yeah, me.
Alright.
Ehome not afraid to flaunt their advantage right now in front of Secret.
Does Earth Spirit have his completed Veil? Yeah. Okay.
Yeah, getting that level 2 Magnetize would just make it a bit sweeter, though. It might be enough to do work. If he can get in, drop the Magnetize, and maybe get himself away... Drop down some extra stones. I mean, Pugna's pretty weak. PS is pretty weak.
This
might be able to get some done, but...
awkward.
But Secret have been a bit discombobulated.
Do Secret really want to fight this? I don't think they do. They still have the Aegis.
Well, they just did a haunt here. Long kick forward is going to catch Kaka. The pullback silence is only going to be on her. The roll's going to be a swing and the miss. However, meanwhile, Old Chicken... Going man mode here on the backside. They are going to get the Magnetize off. It's going to be on the Fan. Old Chicken is going to pursue here for Pi. Pi's going to be going down. Easy kill for him. On the other side, the Magnetize keeps moving forward, and they've only been able to take down Kaka. Secret going to be losing three, and there's a big kick on forward. It is going to land EE a double kill for himself. Turns it into a 3-for-2. This Magnetize continues to move in. He's got only one more stone. Can he get the last one off before he dies? No, it's too late to refresh the Magnetize. Only going to be able to get the Boulder Smash, and Old Chicken is going to live. Four go down for Secret. Ehome will lose two, and they still
are going to be in a very highly touted position. Now the BKB picked up from OD is just going to make them so much better in these upcoming fights.
I'm actually surprised they wanted to fight that, though. Like, they didn't have the tower. They did not have Lycan ulti, but they still have the Aegis. Like, trying to fight into that is just... They just need the 5 minutes, man.
I don't know. Were they figuring a lot was on cooldown at that point? Was Shapeshift already used?
Shapeshift was used.
And, like, that's... maybe Lasso from the other fight, grabbing, Lasso... killing Weeha? It was already back up?
Yeah, Lasso was back up.
All right. I don't know. Maybe they're just like, we stuff's on cooldown. Let's go. Because, yeah, you're taking yourself out of the base and to a tower that's not even there anymore. Definitely feels a bit awkward here from Secret.
The Pugna Ward was a really good spot, like, hidden deep in the trees. Then already sentried the high ground, so they knew that Secret didn't have a vision. Like, all these things were just working against them in that particular fight.
I mean, you're right, though. Who is going to go and get that ward? If he drops it into some trees, like, their only hope is Pylai die. And yeah, Oracle has great attack speed and range, but it's not going to be getting there to get it. And
dang,
this.
That was...
Get the hell out of that base! See you later! He's able to get the magnetize off, but it's barely going to be enough. Pi gonna be forced to false promise himself, still eating hefty right clicks. He might actually just die at the back end of that false promise. Meanwhile, the bear gonna get right clicked up. Yep, he did end up going down. Bear also gonna be dropping.
Oh, his age is just expired.
And oh,
wow.
At the exact moment, no second life gonna be awarded here to the OD.
Wow.
Could have almost maybe even got the game to the back end if they were gonna be able to hold on and move into the high ground here, but they're still considering it. They have the Pugna Blast. This guy is a siege machine right now.
I like how quick 11 is on the... Oh, it's a bad block.
Blocks in. The ward's down. Fan trying to hold on. They're going to decrep him up, which will enhance the damage coming out, and they will be able to burst him down. But now this ward continues to go to work. They continue to roll on forward here. They managed to grab 11. And they continue to pursue. It looks like Lamb's going to be able to make it away from trouble, but they are able to catch out Kaka, and it leads to 4 going down from Ehome, if you do count the start of OD. Maybe the best choice for Ehome was to kind of accept the fact that OD's gone and not coming back and turn around.
Yeah, I think they
around
were more stunned that that happened than anything else. Like, he didn't actually have to pop his BKB there. If he just waited, he would have just died. I don't think they were that vigilant about the Rosh timer, though, and kind of that's your natural reaction when you're in that sort of situation, to pop your BKB, but... It ended up being for the worst.
So this is another opportunity for Secret to make the most...
That's the break they needed.
Yeah, of this opportunity while Ehome are kind of scatterbrained from what actually just happened and recollect themselves. Secret can quickly get across the map, find up their farm, and we gotta see what's gonna be next for him. I'm sure by now, he's past his 11. He just picked up his blade mail now.
How did he
farm
that so quickly? Huh, I guess that...
He might have got a couple of magnetized kills even though he died.
Maybe he got the kill on OD, maybe?
It did linger on for quite a while.
I don't know, but that's a lot of gold.
He did get the kill from OD.
He just got the freaking, like, veil not that long ago.
Or not.
Oh, well, they have double BKBs. Ehome need to make sure they secure the next rush, though. That is definitely, like, what they should be eyeing.
And Necro 3 now complete for Ready Lycan.
Oh, screw this. They want to end the game now.
Here they come.
They got the BKB up.
I mean, what do they have to worry about here? Haunt's on cooldown.
Oh, they have to worry about Radiance on Bear is what they have to worry about.
Echo Slam's on cooldown. He has a blink, but he has no Mighty Echo.
Is it the T3's down, though? That's so appetizing for Ehome. I mean, I don't think they know that they have the blink.
It's just a blink block, if anything. And there's the casual fissure.
Oh, yeah. It seems like they're going to group up for an Echo. This is not good.
It's on cooldown. It's still got, like, 20 seconds, but I think they're just, like, not going to go for it now and go back.
Yeah, I suppose so, but that would wreck their BKBs.
It seems like they're timing the Echo on the side of Ehome here. Or at least they have a general idea of when it's up.
I think they just have a general idea that thing's about to be banned. And they know the Radiance is up, so they got to take it a little bit safe. Oh, that's a fortunate respawn.
Unfortunate for Secret.
Unfortunate for Secret.
Wonderful for Ehome. And, the BKB for Batrider also going to be a huge thing. It still will not, you know, stop someone he grabs from being false promised, but we really haven't seen that all game yet, so maybe he's not too worried. He's been, like you said, doing a nice job making sure Pylai dies, forced to use it on himself, if anything else.
No, he was just insanely quick on the blink, lasso, turnaround, force stab. Like, that happened so quickly. Like, 11 has been executing really well on the Batrider. You just have to be, like, instantaneous on... when and how you initiate.
Maybe he's like a master shift cure or something like that.
That's really difficult to shift Q. I don't even think
some
can.
Of these kind of guys, they got that kind of technology. We'll see.
But you're
so
right.
Now he has BKB. How does he? They need to get the jump though. If they don't get the jump and Earthshaker gets the jump, they immediately haunt and then the Bat Blink is gone. So they have to actually get the jump on the secret.
Unless a big mistake happens, and let's say a certain puppy accidentally enchant totems, gets hit by another ward, can't blink anymore, and it's over.
He has a lot of HP on the Earth Spirit. 1500 HP is...
He comes with some of the highest strength gains in the game, so he gets naturally buff.
So balanced hero.
He's balanced hero.
Why is he a strength hero, though? I guess maybe
What else would he... You need one strength, one intel, one agile. Three spirits, you know?
But he's like an intel hero. In the way that he...
He's dumb as a rock. I think Storm's more of an... No, he's also kind of dumb as a rock. Okay, smoke play. Coming up from Secret here. Maybe they know. Roche could be up now, and it is.
They should not do it, though, without vision.
Oh, the Spy Chuds are going to go for a hunt, anticipating they're in the pit, but haven't even officially moved in, but 11 commits his BKB, rolls up. Secret see this, and they want to turn away, and 11 doesn't know who to commit onto, but he has to commit onto something because he's already eating a lot of damage. He's down to half-life, going to get the pull back, actually ends up grabbing the bear. It's a very awkward start for Ehome, and they might end up dragging themselves into an awkward position, but Secret,
bad.
Yeah, it looks like they're just going to retreat.
The bear for... two BKBs on a haunt?
Yeah.
The bear and a haunt for two BKBs is not that bad.
They
have to commit lasso though. Ugh. Yuck. It was a good blink out from Puppy.
And now, obviously, it's a bit too awkward for Ehome to kind of get back into the pit and get to work here. But, oh, Secret, quick on the prowl. Looking for him. Kick is going to be a miss. Fissure will connect, but he's already able to blink away. Not quick enough on the draw, unfortunately. Oh, look at this. Swap back. Echo only going to catch Lanham here and some Necro books. Magnetize going to be committed out, and the little Pug not going to be going down fast, but Puppy is going to be the response. OD also going down pretty damn fast. Spectre able to shred him apart. They're going to be able to catch Weehaw here. He's going to be stalked apart from 11. As Envy, Misery, and Pileidye look to swarm in, they are going to be able to bring down 11. It's Secret's time to make a comeback here. Fan. Not like in this one. Got to get back into base.
Oh, I can't believe the game changed so much after that one, the Aegis timing. That's a tough break for Ehome and Secret. Very happy with how things have progressed. They've gotten the items that they need, especially the Point Dagger and the Radiance. They're going to get this Roche for free, even with the buyback.
Oh,
wait, the T1's still up.
Uh-oh.
Okay, that's not free.
And Secret quickly go back here.
That's completely worth it that he buys back. They need this Roche to end the game.
Yeah, and... Well, I believe you now. The buyback's committed. This is hugely important for Ehome. They cannot afford to let this game go.
I wonder
on.
If they can put into Secret, though, now that there's no Echo. Because he wasted it as soon as he got swapped.
That's true.
And what's the bear cooldown, too? Bears, 12, okay, well, they'll have two.
And Hunt is also on cooldown, right?
I think Ehome have to go for it, though. They're that sort of team, though, that, like, if there's a decent chance that they will end the game, like, 60-40, they'll just... I'm pretty sure they're just going to do it, because their lineup doesn't go that well late. Yeah, sure, they have BKBs, but, like,
oh, look at this.
Spec.
And maybe Secret try to read the situation, know where maybe Ehome are going to be stepping out from the Roche, and they're looking to position themselves to catch him, maybe? Awkwardly,
it looks like it, but they have
they're
BKBs,
baiting him
man.
Over.
It's,
I don't think it's gonna be here for Secret.
This is
Envy. They saw him and they think the whole team might be behind him here. And they're like, why are they there? I don't want to go over there. This is awkward. Everyone's saying it's awkward. Everyone's like, let's get the hell back.
So, what are they waiting for? BKB on Lycan, that's 1,000 gold away.
Yep.
Still have a tiny bit of timing with the. Aegis expiry. What's that?
SFY
what?
On an OD.
Who? What?
I thought CTY wasn't in this game. Old chicken. Innovator.
What?
Tell me the benefits of SMY on OD and why it's the pick. Maybe he's eventually going to take it apart.
Aethos? Huh. I mean, it gives you attack speed.
I mean,
speed.
All the intel SMY adds, you know?
Oh?
Yeah?
What?
I don't know. Maybe he thought it was like a custom game where you get that third sword where it's an intel sword. I'm not too sure. It's different. I'd love to see the stat on how many times we've seen an SMY on an OD in a competitive game. That would be wonderful.
Almost always the pickup is Aethos versus Lone Druid because you kind of see that matchup a fair amount nowadays. And the bear just kind of gets destroyed by the Aethos. Firstly, like the Radiance Burn is not that effective. And then like the bear just kind of cut out in the middle of nowhere. And that's... It, for good reason, too. And SNY is even more expensive than that. Oh, he's lying.
Yeah, he's dead for sure. A haunt also. Maybe he's hoping that they can get any other stragglers. They spotted out 11, who had been creeping that mid lane for a while.
It's actually not that bad, because they wanted to buy time for the BKB anyways.
Yeah.
And then now they can push without haunt. That's a tiny window, like 30 seconds maybe. And I think that actually could rush for them. So.
So maybe that together, is that a big enough window? The back end of the Aegis, Pugna coming back and moving in with the
when are they going to get a better chance?
I mean, yeah, I mean, there's, it's now or never.
They're going for it.
Here we go, Ehom. This is it. It's a small window.
Yeah.
This game maybe should have come a lot easier, but unfortunately with how things have panned out, Secret now are in a position where if they withstand this push, they can come back and...
That's something that you really want as a Batrider.
Thank you very much, Mr. Frog.
Okay, so who do they drag? Lone Druid has so much gold, it doesn't even matter if he dies. Okay, who doesn't have buyback?
I would say... I don't know. If he goes in, he's gonna get the False Promise. Oh, he went right for Pile I Die, so he can't False Promise anything, so I guess Oracle dead. But he can't buy back, but that means the lasso's down. I don't know if this is gonna be go good for Ehome, but we'll see. Commitment coming in, big Sanity's Eclipse, another buyback, this time for Misery. Weehaw getting choked up in a lot of the damage, and he's gonna be False Promised up. Saved for now, they're trying to heal him and keep him alive. An attempt at the Rax here, but the Glyph's gonna be coming out, and Ehome, I don't think this is gonna be enough to justify their position here, and as the shapeshift and everything goes on expiration, they have to quickly turn tail and run.
How long left on Aegis? Are they going to be able to make another push?
I don't.
Until then?
I don't know.
2 minutes. I think that's enough time. They'll have Lasso up again very soon. And they got the buyback. With that roar kind of owned him. He was going super fast. I guess he was already hasted. Gotta wait for BKB cooldowns at least. Bare minimum.
This window is going to feel even smaller than the other one then. The back end of the Aegis with the BKs up. Haunt will be ready this time.
No Glyph though, and Raindrax is at like 300 HP, so that's, I think that's okay for them.
But no buybacks now on either Misery or Pi.
I mean, it's risky for sure, but their lineup was risky to begin with, picking a Pugna and a Lycan.
What level is Pi? If you don't mind me. I mean, I guess 90 seconds would be the low, if he was level, yeah, he has a level 1, so it will still be back. So do you have to lasso? Oh god, they're gonna make the go. This time for Old Chicken, a good lead and a silence is gonna be able to bring down the Aegis here. 11 on retreat, eating a lot of damage from Envy. And now they make their commitment in. Old Chicken now looking to make a go onto Wii. The Blade Mail not gonna be returning anything as the BKB was dropped. But this is bad. Now they won't have all this for their small window of a push. And maybe a good heads up play from Secret to deny them all this potential. But now look at this, they're gonna make it go for Old Chicken. Swap back, but towards an Echo. This Magnetize is gonna be more than enough to rip right through him. A beautiful setup from Secret. Fan now commits his BKB, chomping at the back here of Weehaw. Changes course, look to go for Pile I Die. He's gonna be False Promised up now, and he's looking to retreat back it away from trouble, it seems. And, it looks like this is a win for Secret. They force Ehome back and away from their base. They're gonna have another period farm up, and at this point, Eho might not have enough ammunition to have another go to the high ground.
Again,
we'll have to see.
Another natural reaction is to pop your BKB immediately as soon as your Aegis pops, but they actually wanted to force that out, and then they backed off, and then they fought when his BKB was down. So very smart play from Secret, and kind of playing the OD very well. This is scary. I think Secret's lineup has stubbed long enough to the point where they've gotten past that hump where their lineup was quote-unquote too greedy, and now it's like, oh, hey, it paid off.
Yeah. And Envy with near 3k gold, I saw. Straight heart? Tank up? A bit? Is it necessary? I mean, obviously it works
I'm not sure
nice with his own abilities, but...
He could also get Blade Mail and just crush them. I don't know. Because normally you'd get Radiance at this point. Because you're very confident in your late game. But you don't need Radiance. Because Bear already has one.
Mm-hmm.
So... You could... Scotty, actually, I think is probably the best.
Oh, I'm assuming Weehaw's going for Agnes too. Okay, kick, pull, roll, haunt, commitment, land him. Alright. Easy setup there. Land him, I'm sure he knew he was putting himself into danger by being in that bottom lane, but he was doing his damnedest to kind of make a safety distance from the rest of his team so they can farm up and just keep this bottom lane moved forward and away from the Ehome. base side.
They're using the haunt very well, though. This is another counter to Batrider. It's having like a, you know, Zeus or a Spectre that just constantly keeps his blink from coming online. And
also, Bear running around with Radiance doesn't help either.
Yeah, there's a lot of stuff that makes old 11's life difficult. So, yep, Secret. Now you're happy if you're in Secret's position.
Mm-hmm.
You are scaling well. And you have a gem on the Bear? Is that a gem? Okay, yeah.
Yep, it's a gem. Oh! Puppy's moving in here. They're looking to get old Chicken. Chicken now forced away, purged up. No mana right now for Envy. He's gonna turn back and away. The Bear making its move in now.
That's helpful. Don't have to pop anything then.
And OD was able to preserve his BKB. Ehomer is still trying their best to move past this river and take it to Secret while they are in their prime. But
Secret actually just need to save for buybacks, because as long as they survive like the Lasso, the BKBs, and the Sandy's Eclipse, or if they just, you know, die and then buyback, they'll be fine.
He went for BKB on the Spirit.
All
right.
It's all the a game ward. Of survival.
Yeah, getting off the most of your magnetize, staying alive, not having to worry about any sort of astral stopping you, magic missiles. I mean, I don't want to be like, that was why they lost the game. I don't feel like it was.
No,
I feel
it was
obviously the, you know, misplay earlier and Secret being able to kind of get all that extra time. But
it's just,
it's very different and awkward.
Yeah.
We'll never know. But we'll see. This SNY.
I mean, SNY is a good item, not that good.
I mean, on some heroes, yeah. It's a wonderful item.
If you really want attack speed, you would just go Moonshard.
Yes.
Moonshard is like 6 times more attack speed than SNY. Not 6 times, but like 4 times. And is cheaper.
Well, maybe this rare opportunity, we'll see if this SNY will end up in the win column or not, but this is all the type for Secret, and they're just happy to kind of soak up the clock. There's the Reaver, so it seems like the heart is in order. So as if the Secret was hard enough takedown.
Yeah, it's getting to the point where Secret's like too far to stop. Like, you just run in with Spectre, and then if you lose a fight, if you lose a high ground defense, you just buy back Haunt and just crush all of them. Ehome don't have the sustain to deal with that. Maybe with Pugna's Scepter, but he's having a really hard time surviving a team.
I feel like offensively, even with Scepter, like the drain is just not
there's
very
too
exciting.
Many stuns.
It's better, like, I imagine he's like, I just want to have it off cooldown so I can keep giving my team life or
yeah,
something.
But if he does, he'll get really low from Spectre.
Oh, yeah, of course. Haunt, so, yeah.
I don't know.
Doesn't it insta-kill illusions? So, I mean, that's nice. He can just boop, pop all the haunt illusions real quick. Maybe that's the game plan. Lanham, what a smart guy. He's like, I'm just going to rid all the illusions
I will cast
one by one.
7 times. 1 for each haunt, 2 for the
He's the Aether Lens. He'll hit all of them. Oh, Lanham. This is it. This
Isn't
is how they're gonna win.
To do all, he actually
he does do it. That would be hilarious. We'll see.
Now they're moving out. They know new Roche is in order. Scouting out with the wolves. Uh-oh, 11 to the skies here. He gets a catch on the Spectre, but just as fast, and I'm sure Nathan Lens is on that Oracle, they're going to be able to take the False Promise here. Quick commitment of the Haunt. Our Secret looking to take a fight because already both BKBs are committed. They might step back and just wait
they're
for
about
the expire.
To get echoed.
Look at this big life drain happening here on Weehaw. Weehaw could be going down, but oh my goodness, look at the magical power just being immersed right here from Secret. Just absolute. Look at this. Lycan is going to be forced out. Old 11 stuck under, he's going to be able to TP away. Lanham, though, still very fragile. Going to be going down. Fan makes it away. And yeah, once the BKBs expire, it's just an onslaught of power coming out from Secret.
They had to commit a lot to kill the Bear. That's the second time that this happened, that the Bear is, like, in a bad position, but it's not really a bad position because after Ehome blows their cooldowns on the Bear, they lose the fight.
So it's going to be Secret now in the pit. Is there a Roche to take? At that point, I don't know. Very little outs for Ehome. It would take a Secret to slip up. And 11 en route to try to mess with them a bit. But you got Bodyguard Eha here, who's not looking to make it away. And look at this. They might actually take down 11 here. Fortune's End, Purifying Flames. He gets the BKB. Who is he pulling him back to here? It looks like right to the Venge. But quickly, a False Promise is going to be coming from Pilot Eye. And he will save his comrade.
He hasn't even had like a false promise into a lasso until like pretty late into the game, and it's still just
yeah. Well, he got the Aether Lens, I think, now, and it's a lot easier for him to stay far away from trouble. But that is now a Roche for Secret. It looks like OD got his Shivas.
Ah, game is slipping away from you, home.
You could just kind of sense the percent to win chance just continuing to just. Trickle down here for Iho.
You sense the despair.
Yes.
Iho, the desperation.
Kaka, I need to take a moment right now and just be like, whew, this game, it slipped away a bit. We wanted to get up in there, and we did, but then quickly realized that we did not have proper protection, had to get back out.
They didn't even get the range racks.
Yeah.
Pulled out too early. Tough game.
That's a lot of
little small things. Like in getting caught twice on bottom by the fissures, I think it propelled him to get the Radiance at that exact time that fight happened,
mm-hmm.
and like, forced him to back off a little bit. What else? Obviously the Aegis expiring at the exact moment that he died, him popping his BKB twice.
SNY.
SNY is like actually less of a big deal than the other two.
Yeah. Bugger. 11 did his thing. The Batrider found crazy good setups up to that point where it was kind of, they felt like maybe Echo Slam was a threat, and then they pulled off. We haven't seen them being able to be in the high ground and a problem for Secret since then, so it just feels like at this point Secret or Ehar are trying their best to throw their bodies across the river and towards the base, but Secret are always there to cut them off along the way and not even have to commit for a full 5v5, but just enough to like rustle their feathers and get their BKBs popped and some spells committed, and they're like, okay. And then step off.
Very good about that, though, because of the Spectre Ultimate. Like, the Spectre Ultimate is just so strong. Like, he can just go in onto Batrider, defusal him, and then he has to, like, you know, pop his 4 staff, probably pop his BKB, and then, you know, that's a large part of their fight is the jump with the Batrider. And then once that's eliminated and the BKB on him is down, then they can just go in.
Still paused up. No idea what's happening. We are on land, right? So hopefully maybe someone in the mall spilled something on him. I heard this was in a mall. Did you hear that?
Yeah.
That's old school.
China, weird stuff happens there.
Right. Go over to your local Orange Julius and watch some Dota. I don't think they have that over there, right? Well, as we continue to wait, Secret looking good. The ramifications of this game, both these teams have not been able to take a series 2-0. They've drawn their series all here. Ehome currently drawing with both Complexity and LGD, while Secret have drawn up against LGD only. And coming off their break, doing something a bit funky here with this mid lane Earth Spirit, which he definitely did his part. Got that first Prime in, got his Magnetize, got that big kill bottom. Could avail in good time, went to work, and was able to hand off here for both Misery and Envy to take over. His potential now is not much. Just kind of get in there, get Magnetizes off. Maybe you can cancel some BKBs and really frazzle Ehome a bit.
Yeah, it's all about popping the BKBs.
Yeah. Frazzle. Here comes Ehome now, and in another, you know, we got to make something happen here. And they will do what they can, ridding of some wards along the way here. 11. Scathing about on his Batrider. And we gotta see here. Captain Lanham, what is the next move here for Ehome to...
There's so many things that Ehome have to bust through. They have to bust through the Aegis on Spectre, a buyback on each of the cores, like the cheese under Earth Spirit. Yeah. There's so many things that they...
Whomever they grab and gets false promised.
Yeah, there's like way too many things that are going uphill for them. And Secret just have to play tight. Like, they just stick close by together, use Haunt very early on fights for vision, and make sure they have a gem in the ward, and it's not that difficult for them. Because they play very well in the first 20 minutes of the game. Or, yeah. In the high ground defense. Ah, ground.
Ah. Such a mistress. Well, the Secret now is they, for the first time in a while, maybe getting in a position where they themselves will consider dabbling and putting their feet across the river a bit. Don't need to worry so much about will they have the time.
If they commit to kill Spectre, they will lose the fight heavily on Ehome. They're like, okay, we'll just put him up in front. Like, you lasso to him, you will straight up lose the fight. If you kill him and pop BKBs, you will also lose the fight.
What's the game changer item here for Batrider? We saw him farming in the jungle. Look at the gold he's got right now. He's playing against something. Was it Refresher, maybe? Double Lasso? False Promise? I'll grab him again anyways and pull him back?
Maybe Scepter? So you can grab grab him plus one?
Grab whoever's near the Oracle and the Oracle, yeah? That'd be cool.
Grab the bear plus one?
Yeah.
It's not that bad.
I don't think he nearly has enough money, though, for that and a buyback. So whatever he's farming for, it's still going to take some time. If it's something as luxurious as that, we'll see if Secret are going to be nice enough to allow the opportunity for him to farm something. After they get the push bottom and the tower, they head to mid where there is still a tier one. Hey, guys, free money. Pick up that one, move on through, and it's just going down the checklist here. And as you said, this, as long as they follow that the tightness, it's keep their ducks in a row, whatever little catchphrase you want to throw out there, E-home. It's on them to kind of mess with the ducks or frazzle Secret now.
Secret just need to not lose her concentration, though.
All right. Blink Dagger, obviously. Very good for setup. This is where you can have fun. You can Rolling Boulder in. Drop Magnetize, then quickly double tap Blink Dagger and get the hell out of there. Then you can just drop stones from far away. And then obviously later on, if he does, for whatever reason, if it does stretch to that late of a game, he can always end up getting the Ags, and then you have the Blink to set up the, of course, Enchant Remnant kick out or whatever.
Would be great, because they can just cast an Oracle if Oracle gets jumped. You're like, eh.
Yeah.
Doesn't matter.
Batrider jumps in, you just Remnant him. Kick the bat into your team.
OD's underfarmed.
Well, SMY, I hope, would farm a bit more.
Oh, ES is BKB. Oh, that's hard. That's hard to play against.
No more pesky ward canceling blink. Whatever it may be, now he has the extra density to get that big dunk off right now. And Secret are smoked up. They trench past the river. A big fight here from Secret may just close the game out altogether. E-Home desperately need a big win, and there's going to be the lead in Hunt. They're going to get the scout out. Old Chicken going to get stunned up, swap back into the safety zone so he can get a BKB off. But that means Kaka is going to be handing over his own life. And this poor little support does not have enough money for a buyback. Look at Weeha just going way in deep. Pops BKB, does get the magnetize off, and is start to drop the stones here. It's going to be a bit difficult for E-Home to kind of approach. Secret get the space, step back, and they will finish off this tier 2 tower. And look at Lanham right now. God damn, this magnetize. He's gonna have to head all the way back in the base to heal up. What do you think, Ben? Just move forward or go for top lane tier 2?
Oh, no, definitely move forward.
Here they come now.
You have Spectre, dude.
You have Spectre. No Haunt, but Vengeful Spirit is still out.
He's saving for a buyback.
Wow, that long kick somehow hit 11 right there. And look at Mr. EOTK go. It is right in. They're gonna be able to take that 11. He's gonna be forced to buy back now. Fan caught up in the mix, trying to man mode against the bear, but the wolf is losing to the bear. And already double buybacks now coming out from E-Home here as they step back 11 back from the dead and quickly canceled Lasso from another False Promise coming out from Mr. Pylite Eye. And Secret are just going to be happy to see E-Home commit so much. They will reposition, step back, and maybe look for the final blow here as Old Chicken knows that this is going to be do or die for game one of E-Home. Can they make something out of this right now? Look at this. Lanham is just getting a full life drain off onto Envy. It is going to end up killing him off. Now he goes for the bear. Decrept up, a casual stun does come out, and it is going to get the kill. OD is going to be down for the count. 90 seconds, no buyback. Lanham continuing to put that Agnums to work. They do manage to bring down the bear. And it will be his next summon. Did Secret even take anything inside the base? They did not. They lost a bit. Was that a solid hold for E-Home? Was that a solid hold for E-Home? Or
got a dieback on OD.
It did cost them a lot for that hold.
And Secret's Aegis actually ran out like a little bit before the end of that fight too.
The classic double defusal. We're seeing a lot of innovation happening here now. Two hands for two swords.
Defusal, I think, is the highest agility per slot per me. It's like what, 35 agility or something stupid
for price point maybe.
40 agility from FB.
Highest agility price per price point. Yeah. Best bang of for your buck actually, if you're an agility whore. Yeah, I could see that.
EB's better. Mass EBs, dude.
Double defusal, huh?
It's good damage. I'm surprised he didn't get Gotti instead. But
he felt heart was plenty. And then you're really going in on the stats. I guess maybe he wanted a balance of power between that and some offense potential. But it is a bit, unique.
The high ground defense, the Pugna life drain is really good, though.
It is pesky, man. It's not really something you, like, pay much attention to. It's just going off in the fight, and you're just kind of like, what is that? Swatting away like a little fly? Yeah, it's Pugna. Sucking at
you. I mean, as you said, though, it's good at killing the Spectre illusions.
Yeah.
And Spectre can't interrupt it.
And you know what? I remember I brought that up, but I didn't even look for it in that fight. I didn't even notice if maybe
he
that was something
at the
he did.
End. He killed the Spectre with it, and then he killed the...
Yeah, I know he used it, but I wasn't saying if he used it as like an anti-illusion mechanism.
Oh, yeah, I didn't see that. But it's still surprisingly good. They just need OD to get more items, though, if they want to continue this into the late game. So, like, Scythe probably on him, or Refresher. He needs two BKBs, actually, so I think Refresher should be kind of a decently high priority for the OD.
Yeah.
His BKB is way too short.
See, I thought that would have been something EE would have considered after maybe late game, like a Refresher, you know? I think it would have been okay.
That's true.
You want more double damage, and you're worried about a Pugna ridding of all your illusions. How about just get a second haunt, my man?
He doesn't have Radiant, though, so his haunt doesn't actually do that much damage.
That's true.
So...
Double Dacker, though, I mean, come on. E-Home, though, okay. They spent a lot here. Are Secret going to want to push... Is there a timing window, I guess, on getting the next Roche and still being able to push against E-Home while they don't have buyback? And it looks like the timer is pretty low here.
Not really.
So
this fight around the Aegis and Cheese.
Yeah.
They fought a little bit too late with the Aegis and weren't able to use it on Spectre. They wanted four lives of Spectre. Or Aegis and then Cheese, then buyback and haunt.
Yeah. And false promise, so that's another life right there.
So five lives. And then you get dispersion. And die.
Yes.
So Butterfly will be the item of choice.
For him, yeah. Okay. Evasion. Obviously no real MKB candidate at the moment here for E-Home, so...
The bear. The bear.
The bears.
The wolf. The wolfman. What's wolfman getting?
What's wolfman getting? Abyssal. All right.
Tired of getting bashed by bear. Gotta bash him back.
Fair enough. He definitely lost the man mode fight he had inside their own base. He was trying to go toe-to-toe with Misery, and it was not going in his favor. And now
COD up top, it means easy Roche. He can't TP and get there in time.
Yeah, there's nowhere close. And as they move in, don't see enough from Oracle's. Good, he's using the Fate's Edict on the Roche itself.
So, who are they going to give Aegis and Cheese to, is a question. EE's slot limited, but he's the best carrier. Misery probably has a slot.
No, Weeha dropped his TP, looks like he'll take the Cheese. Alright. He has to blink in the roll, he can get in there. Quick paramedic, hand off the Cheese, like a football player. I'm sure he could do it. Uh-oh, 11's in trouble. Fissure, commitment, and he's suddenly dead. Oh, goodness, did you see the damage? He just disappeared. Now Kaka even in trouble. Oh, man.
Was there?
She's like, thank God I have a pipe. All right, well, it does cost him a haunt, but Batrider going to be out. No buyback for him. This is where Secret start tiptoeing into the high ground, and they're going to see this Batrider's not buying back, and they're going to go.
They just need to get the OD dead.
Yep, we'll see. Can the mighty Lanham and his tiny, tiny Pugna be enough to hold the high ground here again? We'll see here. Oh, committing in. Lanham goes to work, draining out the bear, forcing him back to creeping him up so he can't attack the tower, but the tier 3 is going to be going down. And Sigurd are going to be sieging here with the help of the bear and Envy, of course. Not even having to be in a bit of a promiscuous position. Sigurd are going to be happy to siege this one out. Still 48 seconds, no Batrider. Racks down. Secret looking to commit for both, or not. They're transitioning to the bottom lane here.
That Pugna drain.
Keep going, buddy. He doesn't have much mana left, though. He can't only get so many more drains off. And it's canceled right away. And they're going to get a hold of Pugna. And he's going down, and he has no buyback. This could be a quick game. Old Chicken's like, this is all or nothing right now. It's time to just go balls to the wall. Drops the Sand Eclipse, tries to man up, right-click it out, but he's getting no one done. They are going to get Misery down, but it is nearly not going to be enough. Secret. In the end, we'll be able to claim game number one. E-Home's window of opportunity came and went, and Secret were able to hold on for a very nice win with a very greedy lineup. And a fun little Weeha mid laner spirit.
they had the great tools to stall though, like the Earthshaker Fissure and the rock stun. Like it just perfectly lines them up if there's two or